Wasn't that tracking edit just beautiful?
Just by looking at the shape of this puzzle, you may not really have an idea of what it is, but it's actually kind of simple. It's this puzzle. This is a 2x2, and I mean, once you start scrambling it, it's a little bit easier to tell exactly what it is. But somehow I managed to find a way to make it look a little bit more interesting than this standard little 2x2 cube. It's a nice little shape mod, but the thing which is really interesting about this puzzle isn't necessarily how it looks, although I'm really happy with how it ended up looking, with a really thick black sort of chamfer over here and then these like opposing colors. The part that's really interesting to me is how long it took me to make this. First off, I got the idea just by looking at all the Penrose Megaminxes and stuff, and I think I saw a Penrose Pyraminx, and I didn't like how it looked, because only the last cube had been curved over. So I wanted to make something with this sort of shape, where it was curved like a little bit more than it was in that Pyraminx. And I wanted to make a mechanism which wouldn't be too hard to make, so I decided to make a 2x2. So I took that design, I like cut it up, and then I just divided it into 8 little cubies so I could glue it onto a cube like this. But the corners of it, they would technically be sticking out of this piece here. So after I'd printed it, I actually had to take it and cut off the tips of the little 2x2 cubie, and then super glue the little 2x2 cubie back together again, which took a little bit of time, but not too much. And then after that, I managed to sand these faces and these faces while the cube was already assembled, so that saved a little bit of time. But the really interesting thing is, from the idea to actually creating this cube, actually took less than a day, including the printing time and everything. Now, I didn't finish the puzzle then, I still hadn't cut the stickers, so I had to design those, send it off to Chewy, and then I got them along with another puzzle, which there may be a video made on somewhat soon from now. But still, like, the ability to take an idea you have and to turn it into reality in such a short amount of time is just so cool to me. So that's how this puzzle was made. It's a little bit, it's a pretty simple puzzle, but I just really like the overall look that it has. And you can do some really cool stuff with it too. So like, you have like this little like, you know, like those creatures that live on the bottom of the ocean or whatever. Sort of looks like that there. And then if you do something like this, you can make like a checkerboard, like a little like flower pattern, or it sort of looks like it quite literally is two cylindrical surfaces intersecting each other, but it looks like the graph of that, like with these two being the two different colored graphs. And you can like do this, so these colors match up. And there's also like, you can do this. The shape looks kind of cool to me. It's really cool, all the different shapes that you can make with it. So I guess the little takeaway that I got from this puzzle is, if you have an idea, don't be afraid to just like go out there and try to make it, because I was really close to not even making this, but in the end it didn't even take that much work. If you have an idea for a puzzle or a design or anything, just go out there and make something. Because the most important thing about getting better at making anything is just to go out there and do it. I wouldn't have gone this far in making YouTube videos if I hadn't started, I don't know, like a year and a half ago. But because of all the time that I've spent working on this stuff, I've really come a long way. Now, if you want to make this puzzle, it is kind of complicated, because the way that these puzzles work is they have these little cap things that clip on. And what you have to do is you have to cut off one of these caps. And then after you've done that, you have to super glue this little part here back onto it. So it's a little bit complicated, but it's not too hard. So if you want to make one of these, I'll put the files up on Thingiverse. Just make sure that you know what you're doing when you're trying to make it. And yeah, don't get your fingers all super glued together. A little bit about the channel. I haven't been posting recently because I went on a trip to China to visit some family there, some friends. And I've been like catching up from that trip for a while now. And I haven't really been able to make videos, but hopefully I'll be able to make more videos soon, because this YouTube channel is really something that I want to invest time in and get better at. I will probably I want to like post some videos, like, I don't know if you guys see them, but like the message things that people can send from their channels. There's like some puzzles that I've been looking at recently, like made by other YouTubers that you guys might find interesting. I think I did that once, but I may be doing that a little bit more just to sort of make up for the videos that I'm not making. But I do have a video which is gonna come out sort of soon, and I don't know when it's gonna come out actually, but I have the puzzle designed and I just need to finish making a video about it, and I'm really excited about that puzzle. So yeah, keep your eyes out for that. Anyhow guys, if you want me to make more videos, go up and tell me up there and I'll see how many people actually respond. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.